Welcome to the cooking job, boy. Hey, I got one for you today. Now, I know my schedule kind of still off a little bit, but we're going to still get that every 2 weeks Friday. But I'm going to go ahead and post this thing because, you know, I want to do something kind of, since my schedule off, very unique for y'all. And today, I'm going to do this here recipe I done back in 1981. And I think y'all going to really love it. And I combined Italian with Louisiana, and I kind of made like a gumbo pizza. And man, it was actually really, really good. I didn't do this on the books. I didn't do it through R&D. It's just something I created on my own. And I want to show y'all how to fix it. And come in the machine, we go to that bad boy. Check this out here. First of all, your meat, you're going to need some sausage. And I got a jalapeno sausage right here. I got me some chicken tenders. That's what I'm going to use for my chicken and my shrimps. Okay, now for your season, you're going to need some Creole, some gumbo filet, some garlic powder. Now you're going to need some corn. Now I use some whole okra, but I'm going to get them cut. I'm going to get them boiled. You're going to need some seafood boil. Some butter, oil, flour. Now, this part here gonna be, if you want a hand tossed pizza, you use hand tossed crust, you can use thick crust. I like thin crust, but I always use these flour tortillas for my thin crust pizza, cause they about medium size. And any kind of cheese you like. I got mozzarella and Mexican full blend cheese. Man, this is here, it's gonna be on, man. This is Louisiana style now. Louisiana style mixed with Italian style, a gumbo pizza. Hey man, let's do this here. Welcome back to the Cooking General. Now you see, you get your water, start boiling. Then you want to go ahead and add the seafood boil. And you can kind of judge that on your own, how spicy you want it. Now, what I'm going to do, I cut my sausage up, but I ain't going to put that in there right now. I'm going to just go ahead, chicken going to take a little bit longer than the sausage, so I'm going to put that in there, bring that to a boil. Now, I ain't trying to hold y'all up, so go ahead and get your chicken boiling, and then we'll add the sausage in later, and then at the last, we'll add the shrimp. And then I'll show you what to do, how to use the okra and corn. We're going to use the same water. Cooking General. Add somebody. All right, there we go. Welcome back to the Cooking General. I got me a little oil in there, a little vegetable oil, and my butter. Now, what you want to do now, we're going to make our roux. We'll add some flour to that. Okay. And I'm going to add a little of my gumbo filet seasoning to that. All right, there. And we're gonna keep stirring it until we get a good golden brown color. The darker you get it, the better. Ask somebody. All right, there we go. We're gonna keep on stirring this here up. We wanna get a little bit darker than that. And now we're gonna go ahead and add some tonus to it. You wanna make sure you get a little seasoning on there. Now, my chicken is about like I want it. About like I want it, not all the way. Let me get back so y'all can see. Film the lens up. Now I'm finna add my sausage. Sausage to the water. And the shrimp's gonna be the last thing you wanna add right now. So let that go ahead and boil with the sausage in there for a little bit. It's done. And don't forget, keep stirring that roux. Ask somebody. Alrighty, here we go. We got roux about like we want it. Alrighty, get a little bit more brown than that. Okay, now. See there, I got my chicken ready for a pizza. Sausage already cut up. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and you wanna wash your shrimps off and you wanna go ahead and add them to the water. Get the seafood boil, let them go. They ain't gonna take long, so just get them a few minutes and you're ready to get them out of there. All right, we got the shrimp ready. Got the sausage ready, chicken. Now, still using the same water. Add some okra, depending on how much you wanna use. And we're gonna let that go for a while, and then we're gonna add our corn. Now I ain't gonna add my corn, I'm gonna let my okra boil a little bit first, and then I'm only gonna use about a half a can of this corn because it's only going on a couple pieces, so I'm only making about two or three of them, so that's gonna be it. All right, come back and I'll show you. Alrighty, now you got your jalapeno sausage. Now this one little quick tip y'all can use. Now I got my chicken already done and all that stuff. I boiled it, but I always like to add a little tonis and a little garlic powder to it too before you put it on your pizza. And I also do the shrimp the same thing. So a little tonis, a little garlic powder. That's where the garlic powder come in at. Alrighty, that's how I want it. I'm gonna keep my okra whole. Now you can cut your okra if you want to, but I'm gonna leave mine as whole. That's why I like it on my pizza. And my corn, I put it in last and then let it here sit in this hot water so we get that Cajun season in it. And now we finna start putting the pizza together. Come back and I'll show you. Alrighty, there we go. Now I got my roux. just right. I will spread it just on there, just like that there. Now, what I want to do, I'm going to go ahead, and you can fix the pieces like you want. I'm going to have just a little small, little just slight mozzarella right here. Just a little bit, like that. Then, I'm also going to take me some corn. Spray it on there like that. And it's that Cajun corn right there. It's got that Cajun flavor because I boiled it in the water. Okay. Let's get that on there. Alrighty. Now, let's go with my okra. And you just kind of place it where you want to. And say you're making a pizza, so you're not really concerned about, you know, how it looks or where you're going with this or what. It's for you. And it's a gumbo pizza. Alrighty. Now, let's go ahead and add a few shrimps on there. There we go. Alrighty. Like I say, we just adding this here the way you want it. Okay, now, let's go ahead and grab some of this chicken. I'm gonna spread it on there like that. Alrighty, yeah, there we go. That's what I'm talking about there. A gumbo pizza. Alrighty, add our sausage. It's the jalapeno sausage, remember? I'm gonna put that on there like that. Let's get that on there. Alright, it's gonna be a good gumbo pizza. Now, add your cheese, favorite cheese. We're gonna go with this flow pan right here. And make sure you spray your pan. Yeah, I use some of this baker's joy to spray the pan so your pizza don't stick. So make sure you do that. And I got my oven preseated for about 375 to 400, depending on your oven. I think mine's at 375. And I'm also gonna put a little more mozzarella on the top of that too. I know that one got in there. There we go. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about right here. Man, I'm telling y'all, keep hanging with the Cooking General. You'll see unique stuff like this here. That's what I do. I do R&D, man. So, hey, I've been doing this over 35 years. All right, we're going to put it in the oven, come back, and I'll show you how it looks. Ask somebody. Oh, there we go, man. Hey, boy, Italian, Louisiana, come and let me show y'all what you're working with here. Check that bad boy out. Got the sausage, your shrimp, your chicken, your okra, your corn. Got the gumbo filet seasoning in there with that roux at the bottom as your man, come on. Let's do this here, man. I told you, Cooking General. Always coming up with something new. And although this kind of old because I did it back in 81. But anyway, man, hey, hopefully we get back on schedule. And I can show y'all some more new things. You know what I'm saying? I just teach basics now. If y'all on this cooking show try to learn how to step, I just teach basics. I'm hoping. But, you know, I got a small following, you know, and I'm glad, you know, because I don't need the big thing complaining about I ain't. Hey, but y'all who watch me a while, y'all know, teach the basics. Hey, change this up. Make it to your own. Man, Cooking General, let's do this here. I tell you, no. Louisiana style, Cooking General. Ask somebody.